We got a problem.
Problem? Or opportunity?
But, sir, were you not supposed to meet Miss Vale tonight?
Alfred, the head of the entire Gotham mob is shot down in broad daylight, and you want me to go on a date. Vicki can wait. Julian Day won't.
No wonder my hair is going white. Ms. Vale, may I come in?
I was expecting Bruce. Did he send you?
I'm terribly sorry. Regrettably, Master Bruce cannot be here tonight.
I see. Somehow I knew this was going to happen.
If I may, it may not be what you think.
It's all right. I understand. I'm sure he does this to every woman he meets.
Master Bruce is married to his work.
Wayne Industries.
Something like that. He's a very conscientious man. Sometimes I worry it may be consuming him.
What do you mean?
Bruce doesn't open up to many people. He barely does so with me, and I've known him all his life. But the way I saw him with you, it's like I've never seen him before.
Alfred, what are you trying to tell me?
I'm trying to ask you, if you'd be willing, to give him another chance.
I know you're here, Day.
You're really off the mark, aren't you? And here I thought you were some great detective.
You're going back to Arkham. The condition you go back in is up to you.
Don't play coy with me. We both know you're really after Maroni's killer. But surely you're too clever to go after little old me. So you're an errand boy for Loeb now. How droll. Hello to you too.
Julian Gregory Day. Even for you, Salvatore Maroni is ambitious.
Now this is a new one. I don't think I've ever been framed before.
So you were framed, were you, when traces of your DNA were found at the scene?
Look, Lieutenant, if I had committed such a perfect crime, I would be more than happy to take the credit for it. But, well, killing Maroni, that's bad for business in my line of work.
Forgive me if I'm skeptical.
You really don't know anything, do you?
Get to the point.
Very well. Someone used my modus operandi to kill Maroni. A mimic. A fraud.
Why would I believe you?
Why indeed?
Ugh! Son of a... Are you out of your mind? You can't be in here. If the chief sees you... I need the evidence for Maroni's murder. Look, I appreciate you bringing in Day, really. But it's over. The case is closed. The evidence was undeniable. All the same. Who do you think you are? Just because you brought him in doesn't make you an honorary cop or something. You don't get free roam of the department. Gordon, something's not right here. It's too easy. Like someone wanted us to go after Day. You act like he's some kind of professional. You act like there's an us. You're an urban legend to most of the public and a criminal to most of the police. There is no us. Besides, Day's a nut job. Who's to say he wouldn't be that careless? Then the method. Day uses a knife, up close and personal. He's no marksman. What are you doing? Don't we have enough problems in this city without making new ones? Again, thank you, but... But it's over. I don't understand, sir. Did you not find Julian Day? I did, but something's not lining up. It's too easy, is it? Bruce, You promised me Maroni would be the end. He wasn't, was he? What is in your head? Do you think all this would please your parents? You throwing your life away like this? And for a man like him? Now isn't that a change of tune? A week ago you were congratulating me on a job well done, telling me how proud they would be of me. Now it's that I'm throwing my life away? Yes, sir. Because I see the path you are going down, and I assure you it is a dangerous one. I don't want you to lose yourself. I won't lose anything. Oh, yes, you will. You've already started. Have you even considered that you abandoned Miss Vale last night? I had to catch Day. And what now? Day is in custody, and everyone but you has closed the book on the matter. But you keep going, digging for something that isn't there. Why? 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 Because it's what I have to do! I made a promise, Alfred. Not just to take down Maroni, but to never let another child go through what I had to. To never let anyone I love get hurt again. You can't keep that promise. Yes, I can. I'll call Vicki. Set up another time. I'll just go out with her earlier. Leave time for Batman. I can do both. Eventually, you'll have to make a choice, sir. And when that time comes, I pray you'll make the right one.
All right, what do you want, Bruce?
I'm sorry, Vicki. I'm sorry I didn't show up. I'm sorry I didn't call. I have no excuse.
Well, at least you're honest. You're lucky your butler came by the other day to explain. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't have answered your call.
Alfred's always looking out for me. But whatever he said, it doesn't change things. The truth is, I really do want to get to know you. There was just, something standing in the way. Now, I am dying with curiosity to see this restaurant you picked out.
What's the matter, Bruce? Never been to a mom-and-pop place before?
No, actually.
Well, I would have felt pretty out of place at the restaurants you're used to.
Oh, so instead you make me feel out of place.
I thought you could see how the other half lives.
What can I get you two?
I don't know. What are you thinking?
Two of my usual, Frank. Make his a double.
Coming right up.
So, you're a regular.
My parents used to take me here all the time as a kid. These days, it's one of the few family-owned businesses left in Gotham. One of the few Maroni and his lackeys didn't get to.
I'm sorry you had to see that at the courthouse. It's not easy to watch someone die.
Even if he deserved it?
Even then.
All I can think about is, who would have the guts to kill him?
Well, the head of Gotham's crime family has his fair share of enemies.
Try everyone in the city. And the worst part is, it won't change anything. Someone else will just take over and pick up where he left off.
You're right. It's sad what's happening to this city. No matter how much money is poured in, no matter how many projects are funded, it seems like there'll always be the mob. Crooked cops, corrupt officials.
But that doesn't mean we should give up. And hey, this Batman character seems to be shaking things up. Maybe he's what Gotham needs to turn things around.
Maybe.
Two bonfire burgers, one single and one double. Enjoy.
You know something that was the best burger I've ever had? On the spicy side, though.
I like a little heat on my food.
So do I, but I'm pretty sure that was more than just a little.
I guess I'm just used to it. Well, isn't this about the time that you asked me to go home with you?
I didn't think you were that kind of a woman.
You'd be right there.
Look, I know you've probably heard about my lifestyle, and me flaking on you last time certainly didn't help. I just want to tell you that all that, it's not me. It's just an act, a facade.
And what would that facade be hiding behind it?
I can't tell you that.
A man of mystery. How exciting.
You know who I am, what people think of me. If you felt this way, why did you agree to this?
I wanted to make sure.
Make sure of what?
Does that answer your question?
I think it does.
I don't know, Commissioner. Something about this whole thing doesn't line up.
The evidence was undeniable.
Exactly. Even a crazy like Day has better sense than to leave full fingerprints on a bullet casing. It's too simple.
What are you suggesting, Dent?
That maybe we're looking at this the wrong way. That maybe whoever did it is still out there.
Welcome, friends, colleagues, fellow Gothamites. As the song goes, it's the most wonderful time of the year.
But my parents used to tell me that it wasn't so wonderful for a lot of people. While we sat warm around the fire, many in Gotham were out in the cold, with no place to stay. While we shared a warm meal, many were starving. While we wrapped presents around the tree, many didn't have so much as a few dollars to spare. But in spite of all that, they too called this the most wonderful time of the year. Not because of the snow, or the food, or the presents, but because we have the opportunity to make it wonderful for those less fortunate. And that's what you've all chosen to do by coming here tonight. So from the Wayne family to you, thank you. And Merry Christmas.
You, my friend, should be in politics. Why, thank you, buddy. Let's hope it convinced some of the high rollers. Hey, see that girl over in the corner? Wow, am I right? Nope, I'm reformed. I've only got eyes for one these days. Good. Last thing I need is competition from you. See you around, pal.
I hope I didn't make you lose your concentration earlier.
Ah, well, I've never been much for speeches anyway.
Well, I have to admit, you do know how to throw a party.
Well, it comes with the territory.
I appreciate what you're doing here, Bruce. All of this. You may not think that you're making a difference, but you are.
We're making a difference. All this doesn't mean a thing without an honest voice in the media informing the people. And let's be real. You've been at this way longer than me.
Then to us.
To us.
Wonderful party, Bruce.
I'm glad you're enjoying yourself, Mr. Mayor.
Oh, please. Just Hamilton to you, son. I knew your parents so long ago, you're practically family to me.
Is there anything I can do for you, sir?
Well, as I said, your folks were very good friends of mine, and truthfully, I was hoping a little of that goodwill would be passed down.
You want to know if I'll support your re-election campaign?
Precisely, my boy.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make my position very clear. If my parents were in any way close to you, they apparently were not aware of your true nature. I have no intention of supporting a mayor who has allowed our city to fall so low at best, and profited off of it at worst.
That's a very serious accusation, I can assure you. I have done everything in my power to improve Gotham, and if you think that fool Loeb can do any better, you are severely in error.
I'll take my chances, sir.
I'd caution you not to cross me, boy.
Why, Mayor Hill? That almost sounded like a threat.
Not at all, my dear. Merely some words of wisdom.
That was bold, even for me.
Hill doesn't scare me. What he's done to Gotham, though, that's another story.
Well, the projections are looking pretty close so far. I guess we'll just have to hope that Loeb can beat him out in the end.
Guess so.
Would you excuse me for a moment? I'll be right back.
Of course. So, what does Stephanie Brown do for a living?
You might say I'm into finance, money management, and all that.
Ah, banker, huh? Very impressive. I can barely manage my own wallet.
Hey, even bankers have trouble with that from time to time.
Oh yeah? Go figure. And here I was, thinking I was intellectually outclassed.
And what exactly do you do that's so small-minded?
Well, actually, I'm a...
Someone someone to kiss, someone to miss. When you're away, to hear from me today, to be loved, to be loved. Oh, oh, what a feeling to be loved. Some wish to be a king or a queen. Some wish for fortune and fame. But to be truly, truly, truly loved is more than all of these things. Oh, oh, someone to kiss, someone to miss.